26-year-old Michael is looking for love.
There he is.
I am a very charming guy, and I am quite a bit of a romantic. My great auntie Chris says I'm a lovely looking lad.
Dum 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 de dee dum dum.
He's had romances in the past.
This is my dating history. Ex-girlfriend number one, 2002-2003. Ex-girlfriend number two, 2003-2004. Last but not least, ex-girlfriend 17-2012.
But although 17 girls have made it onto Michael's list, some of his relationships have lasted no longer than a few days.
I can rush into things and that can cause problems. It can put the woman off me.
But anywho, life happens. I mean, people move on.
Recently, he's tried online dating, but hasn't found it easy.
You have to be careful dating websites. It could be some fat 60-year-old Nigerian sex killer.
Do you want to find the one?
Of course I want to find the one, don't we all?
Michael has autism, which means he finds relationships difficult.
People like me find it hard to express my feelings because I express my feelings in an odd way. Wish I just expressed my emotions to people properly.
Does it ever feel lonely?
It does.
He's determined to find the right woman.
So I want a woman to make my mind, body and soul all into one. I'll say it myself once more for the camera. I would like to find love.
He hits the dance floor in a bid to impress Kirsty, and in the hope of getting a date.
I kind of liked you, but it's up, it's your choice.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Think about it anyway.
Yeah.
I do like you.
Yeah, thanks. Hear that? Number 16 says she likes me. Yeah, she says she'll think about it. Mark my words.
Yeah. Kirsty, and we'll try to arrange for a time for you to meet.
And what about the business card? Should I give that or is that to later?
You can give it now if you like.
I'm sure I'll give it to you now, Kirsty, if that's all right.
Is that okay?
Yes, fine. Thank you very much, Michael.
Yeah.
With a date looking likely, Michael's leaving on a high.
Three.
Yeah, respect.
That's it.
Yeah. Well, they don't call me Mr. Popular for nothing.
Michael's meeting his blind date in a local cafe. He's put in hours of preparation to make sure the date goes as well as possible, and even arrives 15 minutes early.
I shall wait till... I'm sorry they're late. It's just... These things happen.
A chaperone from the dating agency is accompanying his date, Helen, who is 31 and has a mild learning disability.
Hi. Are you Helen?
Yeah, I'm
Helen. Michael, by the way.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you. Okay. Let's see.
Despite his preparation, Michael's nerves mean he's forgotten how to start a conversation. But he remembers his mum's email with advice.
Let's see what it says. What do you like to do during the day? It's just an example.
I've got a puppy.
Oh, okay. What's your favourite colour?
Pink.
What sort of music do you like?
JLS.
I'm into JLS as well. What's your favourite TV programme?
EastEnders.
I'm into EastEnders as well. I'm also into Coronation Street, or Corrie for short.
Yeah.
Well, I guess you and I have some things in common.
Yeah.
Now, I don't need to practice my phone. I can put my phone on one side.
Yeah.
Well, I should tell you a bit about myself. I am a gentleman with an ordinary way of looking at the world.
I'm okay. A bit shy.
So am I, but we have to get the hang of these things, won't
yeah.
we?
Yeah.
Well, if you're going to ask me how many girlfriends have you had...
How many girlfriends have you had?
Aha, a gentleman never tells.
Okay.
How many boyfriends have you had?
I'm not allowed to tell you. Secret.
Yeah.
With the conversation going well, Michael builds up to the next big step.
So, Gotta think of this question before I say it. I was wondering if you'd like to go on another date with me.
Yeah.
Well, I'll give you a chance to speak.
Yeah, I will.
This is my business card, my contact details.
Ooh, posh, posh.
Yeah, but this is meant to be a lovely surprise, so...
I can't wait.
Well, make sure you keep your eyes closed.
Yeah, I am.
Here you are. Hope you'll like it.
Thank you.
Is it okay if I give you a kiss on the cheek?
Yeah.
Thank you, that's all for the day.
Thank you.
He's really nice. I had butterflies on my tummy.
Has anyone ever given you a rose?
No, first time. I was going to cry. Oh. I'd like to see him again.
I definitely want to see Helen again. I had a great time and we chatted about some of the things we had in common. It's the first successful date I've had in years.
Caroline, I'm ringing from Stars in the Sky.
Yes, is there anything you'd want to update me about?
I've just been in touch with Kirsty,
but it turns out that Kirsty has actually decided that she wouldn't be able to come on this occasion.
That's right.
Yeah, she really liked you and everything, but then she just thought maybe
she might be looking for someone that is
up to maybe 21 years.
21 years, well.
Yeah?
Yeah.
But other than that, she thought you were really, really super cool.
Yeah.
Bye for now.
Bye
for now, Caroline. Bye. Oh, why is everything so difficult?
How does it make you feel about finding a girlfriend?
It's kind of like I'm going up and down like a yo-yo. It's all these emotions.
Is that difficult to deal with?
It is difficult to deal with. Yeah, I think dogs are better company than women anyway. Even though I'm allergic to them, I'd like a nice little minpin or a Bichon Frise that's hypnogenic. Could keep them on walks. Until they finally pass away and I'll be on my own. Can't bear it. Can't really bear it at all. Might as well accept that I'm a loner. And